Greetings to all and welcome to the final session, that is 10th session of Unit 3 on the reciprocating the machine. The course code is 15NE43T, Machine Tool Technology, for 4th semester diploma in Mechanical Engineering. So today we are just brushing up what you have studied in the earlier classes. We have finished with this unit, so only you are brushing what you have studied from the beginning. So, reciprocating machine tools in which the three machines will come, that is shaper, planer and slotter. The shaper, as you know that it is a reciprocating machine tool in which the ram holding the tool reciprocates over the stationary workpiece in a horizontal direction. The main parts of the shaper is ram, tool post, clapper box, table, base, guideway, and the apron, saddle, etc. You can see here, ram, this is the tool post, tool head, table editing screw, cross rail, feed disc, column, ram. So these are some important parts of the shaper. Classification of the shaper based on the drive mechanism, we will divide it into crank type, gear type, hydraulic type, based on the ram travel, horizontal shaper, vertical shaper, standard shaper, universal shaper, push type and draw type shaper. Specification of the shaper, maximum length of spoke, maximum size of the tube that can be held and machine, type of drive, power input of the machine, floor space required to establish the machine, weight of the machine in tons, cutting to return ratio, angular movement of the table. So in a shaper, the cutting action takes place during forward stroke and the return stroke is idle. So during the return stroke, the tool has to come at a faster rate compared to forward stroke because it is an idle one, there is no metal cutting takes place. Then if you want to increase the production time, you have to achieve the return stroke in a much higher, less time compared to forward stroke. So this mechanism is achieved by means of a quick return motion mechanism that will be studied in a second this one. Shaper mechanism. So the different shaper mechanism for achieving the quick return motion mechanism is crank and slotted lever mechanism, Whitworth quick return motion mechanism, hydraulic shaper mechanism. Crank and slotted lever mechanism in which the forward stroke is much taken at a higher angle beta and return action takes place with a lower angle alpha. The beta is always greater than alpha, that means the forward stroke takes much time compared to return stroke. It is achieved by means of using a crank that will rotate at a uniform angular speed. That crank is connected to by means of a pair BC. The angle AC is fixed. The extreme position of the this slotted bar AP1 and AP2 are tangential to the rotation of the crank. As the ram moves from R1 to R2, the cutting action takes place, and when the ram moves from R2 to R1, the return stroke takes place. The forward stroke takes place when the ram moves from the angle B1 to B2, that is much greater than 180 degree, you can see. So that much time is required for cutting stroke, and the return stroke happens when the crank moves from the angle D2 to D1, which is less than 180 degrees. That means it will perform at a higher speed than the forward crank. The hydraulic shaper uses a piston and piston rod mechanism. The piston rod is connected to the ram. The end of the piston rod is connected to the ram. As we are using a pump for discharging the fluid at a higher pressure to the ends of the piston according to the requirement. Valve mechanism is used for supplying the pressurized oil at either end of the workpiece as per the requirement. So when the pressure oil is applied at the left side of the piston, it pushes the ram towards the forward stroke, towards the right side to perform the forward stroke. And the pressurized oil passes from the left side of the piston. It pushes the ram towards the right side to perform the return stroke. The quick return mechanism is applied by varying the stroke length of the piston. The stroke length on the left side is very less compared to the stroke length on the right side of the piston. In that way, the quick return mechanism is achieved. So in the next session, we have studied about cutting speed, feed and depth of cut. Here the cutting speed is the speed at which the rate at which the metal is removed from the workpiece. It is expressed in meter per minute. It is given by the formula N into L 1 plus M divided by 1000, where N is the number of double strokes, where L is the length of stroke, M is the return to cutting ratio, S is the cutting speed. Depth of cut is the thickness of the metal removed from the workpiece. It is perpendicular to the perpendicular distance between machined and unmachined surface. It is expressed in millimeter. Feed is the relative movement of the tool or work perpendicular to the axis of reciprocating of the double stroke, and it is expressed in millimeter. So it is the perpendicular movement given to the workpiece for one relative moment of forward and return stroke, one complete double stroke, that is forward and return stroke of the tool. It is expressed in millimeter. Machining time is the total time required for machining the complete job. It is given by the formula T equals to L into B, where L is length of the job, B is the breadth of the job, 1 plus M, M is the ratio for return to cutting ratio, return stroke ratio, return to cutting stroke ratio. S is cutting speed. F is feed per feed in millimeter. So in the next class, session, you have studied about the planar machine. So in case of planar machine, the workpiece which is placed on the table reciprocates along the horizontal direction and the over the stationary workpiece. In case of planar machine, here the workpiece is movable and the tool is held stationary. So it consists of a table upon which is having a T-slot which is mounted on the base. The base size of the base is 2 to 3 times greater than the length of the table. It is having a two vertical housing, which is also known as column. This housing is connected by cross rail at the top. So we have horizontal cross rail upon which the tool slides are mounted, which will give cross feed and longitudinal feed. We have tool slide tool part slide side tool. Tool side also for giving the horizontal and vertical slides, vertical feed. The difference between the shaping and planing is that in case of shaper, the tool is moving and the work is stationary. In case of planer, the workpiece is moving and tool is stationary. quick return motion mechanism is supplied to the RAM, whereas the quick return motion mechanism is supplied to the workpiece. It is suitable for it is a light machine and it handles only small jobs, whereas in planar machine, it will heavy duty machine, it will handle larger workpiece. In shaper, only one single point cutting tool can be used in action machining, whereas in planar, more than one cutting tool can be used in action during machining. Principle of planar. Planar used for performing horizontal machining, horizontal and vertical surfaces, and also cutting keyways, grooves. Specification of the planar: horizontal distance, this horizontal distance between two columns, vertical distance from the table to the horizontal crosswise when it is in the top position, maximum length of the table travel, length of the bed, the length of the method of drying, horsepower of the motor. Next is slotter. The slotter machine, which is very similar to the shaper machine, it is also known as a vertical shaper, because here the the tool holding the RAM reciprocates over the stationary workpiece. In case of shaper, the tool holding the RAM reciprocates in the horizontal direction, whereas in slotter, the tool holding the RAM reciprocates in the vertical direction. This is the only difference between the shaper and the slotter. The slotter is mainly intended to produce keyways slots in the internal keyways and internal slots, which is the best choice for a slotter machine. Is the best choice for performing the internal keyways and internal surfaces for cutting keyways slots in the inside diameter. So compared to all the reciprocating machine, the slotter machine is an economical machine. It is available at a cheaper rate. So these are some important parts of the slotting machine. We have round table here, which can be either power driven or hand driven. This is the RAM, which reciprocates, carrying the tool reciprocates in the horizontal direction, vertical direction. So we have gear mechanism for automatic feeding of table here. This is the cross thread upon which the table is mounted. This is the column. This is the RAM. The specification of the slotter: stroke length of the RAM, diameter of the rotary table, the maximum cross and longitudinal travel of the table, power of the motor, type of quick return mechanism used, total weight of the machine, and the floor space required. The difference between the slotter and the planar is that in the slotter machine, again the workpiece is stationary and the tool is moving, but in the horizontal direction. In case of a planar machine, the workpiece is mounted on the table, reciprocates in the horizontal direction, and the tool is stationary. The planar is intended to work on heavy duty large workpieces, whereas the slotter is used for the small workpieces. In a planar machine, we can accommodate more than one tool at a time, but in a slotter machine, it is not possible to accommodate more than one tool. It will accommodate only one single point cutting tool that is made up of high speed steel at a time. So shaper, the planar slotter is intended for small jobs, whereas the slotter planar is intended for heavy jobs. So the floor space required by the slotter is very small, whereas the floor space required by the planar is very large, and the cost of the planar machine is very high compared to the price of the slotter machine. So this is about the reciprocating machine. So this completes the unit 3, reciprocating motion. I hope you understood everything with all these sessions and the videos. I am able to convey this reciprocating motion unit in a very better manner. I hope all of you understood this chapter. Thank you for cooperating with me. Thank you for watching all the videos.